Let's create a line that is the average of two other lines in Adobe Illustrator. So to demonstrate the use case of finding the average between two lines, I want you to try and think of a way to draw a line that is shaped like an S. And if you haven't thought about that question before, it is actually harder than you think, unless you know this method. So one way you might try is to grab the pencil tool and simply draw an S freehand. And I don't know about you, but I'm definitely not that good at drawing letters. So now let's delete this shape. So what you want to do instead is simply to pick the type tool and type an S. And to customize this S, we need to select the S, right click it and click create outlines. But now we have an outline of the S and not a single line that is shaped like an S. So let's try to make the S a stroke instead of a fill. And here we can see that it's an outline and not a stroke. So another way you might think of for creating a line that is S-shaped is picking the scissor tool, cutting a hole in the path, right here, and another hole, right here. Then grab the direct selection tool and delete these anchor points right here. So now we have two separate S-shaped lines. So if I right-click the paths, go to ungroup, right-click again and click release compound path, we can pick one of these lines right here. But as we can see, they are not really S-shaped. This one has a huge curve at the top and a tiny curve at the bottom. And this one is the opposite. So let's go one step back. But what we really want is a line that is the average of these two lines that goes just in between these two lines. So this is where this average technique comes into play. So the steps we did so far were still needed. This means that we now have two separate lines that goes parallel to each other. So now we can select both lines, go to the blend tool right here, then click on the first line right here, and then simply click on the other line right here. And now an average line has appeared in the middle of the S. So with the S still selected, simply go to object, go to expand and click OK. Then right click the S and click ungroup. Now we can pick the selection tool and pick this middle line right here and drag it to the side. And here we have a perfect S as one single line. This means that we can add something like this stroke effect right here that is shaped like a snake. If you want to learn how to create this snake brush, you can click on the video on the end card right now. Thank you for watching.